In this video, we're going to review how to add and subtract numbers correctly when we're paying attention to significant digits. So the rule for adding and subtracting is that we round to the crudest precision of any of the participants in the problem. And I'll explain what I mean by working a couple examples. In the first example, we're told that two volumes of liquid are measured with two different instruments, giving a value of 27.9 milliliters, and then a more precise value for the second measurement of 3.15 milliliters. We're asked to compute the total volume and express the answer in scientific notation to the correct number of significant digits. Of course, the total volume is just the sum of these two numbers, and we arrive at a sum of 31.05 milliliters. Now we're going to round off to the correct number of significant digits, and the reasoning behind the rule here is that 27.9 has uncertainty in the tenths place. The 3.15 has uncertainty in the hundredths place, and so that uncertainty in the tenths place makes it so the hundredths place becomes irrelevant. So this tenths place is the crudest decimal point of the participants in the problem, and we should express our answer with uncertainty in the tenths place, in other words, rounding it off to the tenths place. We round up when we see a 5, so 31.1. And we've got the correct number of significant digits, but in this problem we are asked to state the answer in scientific notation as well. So we'll move the decimal place one space to the left and write it as 3.11 times 10 to the first milliliters, and we're done with that one. In the second example, we're told that a container of salt has a mass of 1.85 kilograms. So you can imagine weighing this on a rather crude scale that handles larger masses. And we remove and weigh a sample of salt with a mass of 127 grams. So that's a more precise scale designed for weighing smaller masses. We want to compute the remaining mass of salt in the container and express our answer with the correct number of significant digits. Of course, the remaining mass in the container requires a subtraction problem. So we have 1.85 kilograms minus 127 grams, but we need our units to match here. So we're going to convert those grams to kilograms. I have 1.85 kilograms minus 0.127 kilograms. Then I can get the subtraction done, and I get 1.723 kilograms remaining in the container. Then I have to round off to the correct number of significant digits, and again, I look at the original participants in the problem, expressed with the same units, and I ask which one of these is rounded to the crudest decimal place, and in this case, it's the hundredths place on that first measurement. If there's uncertainty in the hundredths place, then certainly we aren't going to express an answer to the thousandths place. That's the reasoning behind these rules. I round my answer off to the hundredths place, and I get 1.72 kilograms, and we're done with that one. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.